Hello guys, welcome to Gusto Reactions once again. Happy New Year to you guys. Of course, we wish you all the very best this new year as you continue to enjoy our shows, our programs. We have a whole lot of new and exciting shows to bring to you in 2021. But of course, this is Gusto Reaction. I've got Lala in the building again. And of course, it's a brand new year. And of course, we know that a lot of fans are expecting some really, really amazing content. Of course, also songs from artists.
Yeah.
Davido has been doing a whole lot in Ghana. You know, like you said, he's been, flaunting his, wealth. He's been talking. He's been doing a whole lot. Of course, we have Ichok. We have Tule. Wizkid has been talking. Wizkid said, oh, that video for Ginger is coming very soon.
Focus.
Burna Boy. Burna Boy also is doing his thing. Focus. Who is not focused?
Whiskey is focused on the music.
Tule Jari. Burna Boy as well is also gearing up to attend the Grammys in 2021. Mm-hmm. We've got Tiwa Savage as well doing our Queen thing. Of course, Yemi Alade as well. Kiss Daniel. We've got Zlatan Naramali. We've got Mobad, of course, that one. Of course, Omalay as well with that one. Godly, there's been a lot of amazing songs came out, last year. Even the tail end of last year, a lot of amazing songs. Of course, KPK was one of those songs. Mm-hmm. Now, artists have been giving themselves a run for, their money, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And 2021 is here, Lala.
Mm-hmm.
The first hit this year, will this go to an unknown artist or a major artist? And who do you think will give us the first hit in 2020 in Nigeria?
Well, I haven't thought long and hard about where the first hit might come from.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, last year the first hit was DJ Neptune. That was the first hit of
that actually proved to be like one of the biggest songs.
Yeah, and indeed they were, I mean, if they did top 20 songs last year, I mean, for me, I would have chosen that, and incidentally it was the first hit of the year. So I mean, maybe perhaps if KPK had been dropped in maybe like July, but that Nobody was really banging. DJ Neptune milked it so hard, like there's like what, 20 remixes
already.
So yeah, this year I don't think, I mean, there's going to be a new artist that's going to break out. I mean, I haven't seen, maybe perhaps it's too early, but then last year we had Omalay break out, we had Teams, mm-hmm. we had Thames, and so other new artists broke out.
Yeah.
So those guys would want to consolidate on their efforts this year. Bad Boy Teams is hot. His last song, which is not a bad song, I think he may want to consolidate on that.
Have fun,
yeah. I just want to have fun. So yeah, I think he may want to consolidate on his efforts. Also, there's also Rema who's coming up with an album in the first quarter.
Mm-hmm.
That may pack the hits we're looking for, but it's not particularly a new artist.
Yeah.
And there's also people who haven't dropped singles in a while. Who would want to do the same?
Yaya,
perhaps, but I don't think one song would do it for him. He needs to do a couple of months. Then also the big guys. Okay, fine. I think Burna Boy is due a song, post album song.
I think so.
Yes, because around this period last year was when he dropped. What did he drop first? Was it Odogwu? After his album
Odogwu,
yeah, he dropped Odogwu as another single. So I think Burna Boy is due a new song. Wizkid is not due a new song yet because he's not done with Made in Lagos. Adekunle Gold is due a new song.
He was in the studio some days back, this video of him displaying stuff in the studio, and his wife told him, Oga, when you are done, come on, breastfeed your baby.
Let's try a kiss. So yeah, he's doing a new song post album.
Mm-hmm.
Tiwa Savage is doing a new song post album.
New song?
Yes.
She's still dropping videos.
Yeah, but August was when she dropped the album. These guys I'm mentioning are people who have dropped albums in a while, and then it's time for them to move on from that album. Wizkid, no, is still going to be on Made in Lagos. Davido is still going to be on what's it called?
Boy, Better Time.
A Better Time. But it seems he's gearing up for a new song. Today, that seems to be a song. So, where is the new hit going to come from? If Davido drops Tule because he already wet the ground, he has already planted the seed of Tule in people's minds.
Yeah.
The same way he did with Femme. I think that may just be the first hit song of the year. But then the guys who are going to give him a run for the money, the guys who need to release singles, Adekunle Gold needs a new song.
Fireboy
is, although his album underwhelming for me, doesn't say it's not a quality album, it's underwhelming. Yes, he does need some, but I don't think he's done particularly with Apollo. He still needs to drop a few more videos of songs on Apollo. And still, Olamide album still there, still popping. He still needs to drop. Normally, I would have said, but he just dropped two new singles, which he's trying to push, and those songs seem to be slowly going in people's minds. Zlatan has Money No Day Lagos, which is still going to be pushing. I don't think he's going to drop a new song anytime soon. So a lot of these guys who are our perpetual
hit makers.
Like every year, they've all dropped around October, November, December.
Last year.
So January, they may just take a chip and just watch. So I think January is a year for a lot of these guys who didn't make an impression last year. The floor is open. There's no much grab by anybody who wants to drop in January. If you have a song that you think is a hit, January is that time. Because a lot of these top guys will just be watching and relaxing and taking a break and see what's going on. So if you don't want any sort of any sort of competition with anybody, just look at January, and if you know that song is a dope song, I'm gonna put it out. Never can tell, but I'm tipping. I think Davido will drop Tula in January. I think he will, and if he does, I think that might be the first hit song of the year.
Why do you think Tula will be the biggest song, you know, in this, you know, first days of the year, like the first hit of 2020?
For Tule, I see a reuse of a strategy that has worked. The same strategy worked for Femme. He's planted the seeds of this song already. Now there's a Tule challenge. A lot of people are doing Tule, and the song is not even out yet. You see, even when you book people doing Tule challenge, it's a Tule. They need to laugh and say, you know, client way, Tule. I mean, a lot of people who say he's a vibe, he's been himself, he's been catchy. But then I don't want to diss the video, but Baba Yovendagba. But it's good for his music, it's good for his brand. That's what people know him as. But then I think perhaps he hasn't gotten to that level of chilliness right now. I mean, I think he will get there one day, but right now he's still young at heart and young in the mind.
But don't you think it's a very dope marketing strategy for a song that you make it, you know, implanted in people's hearts before you drop?
Miyakun
does it.
Yeah, that's why I said it's a strategy that has worked for him before and he's trying to.
Is it a dope strategy or not?
Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Zlatan does the same thing as well. Zlatan did the same thing with what? The Matter?
Yeah.
That didn't work out too well. He did the same thing with, what's the song with Ebosebe? Egungun Be Careful.
Yeah,
he jumped on the trend and they did their Egungun Be Careful, still did not work out. So it can work and it cannot work. But then if Tule,
why does it work for Davido all the time?
How many times has it worked for him? Maybe just once with Femme.
Femme. Well, he choke. If he had released it, he choke as a song.
I'm sure he would have just, see, these things are buzzwords, and which will now come to, our next video, we'll now talk about how these buzzwords are necessary and how they are important for artists and how why artists jump on them, because there's always the potential that these buzzwords make the song go viral. I mean, when you started it up with Gang,
Gang of Lagos, of Lily,
buzzwords turned into hits and all that. So yeah, it's a good strategy, because yes, there's already the ground already says that this buzzword is popular among people, let me just need to do a song. The biggest song at the moment is a buzzword.
Davido said, he choke done the go. The new word now is, the new slang now is Tule. So, he choke was popular then, then Tule. can we say that Davido is the new king of slangs?
But who started the choke? Maybe Peruzzi started.
I think Peruzzi, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm pretty sure someone else around him started Tule and then he just popularized it. So yeah. But yes, we have to give him the credit. He popularized Tule.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. I was just about to say that. Yeah. Lala, are you going to give him his flowers or not for
no,
Tule?
I already gave him his flowers now. The slang is catchy and yeah. It's all over the place.
So you think that Tule is going to be the very first big hit of 2021?
I think so, yeah. I don't see any other...
I don't see anybody competing against this particular hit that you think will become...
No, the people that might compete with him, they've all dropped songs November, December. So it's hard. It's hard to see. Hard to see.
Okay, Davido's Tule. Yes, Tule, though. Tule, Dari. Tule.
Cool down.
And that was the kind of life he laughed and everything. No, yeah, I got it. Tule, dog. Tule, Dari. Tule. Shout out to David on that one. Yes. Tule, Dari. Yes, Lala is of the opinion that is going to be the very first hit of 2021 because, of course, Wizkid is not dropping anytime soon. Burna Boy as well is due for a new single. Adekunle go due as well. Olamide is not due for a new single. Tiwa Savage is due for a new single. Yemalade.
So she just dropped an album.
Okay, so she's also not due for a new single yet. Guys, Davido has an all clear way to drop Tule and of course to become the very first hit of 2021. Guys, what do you think about that? What exactly do you think or who will drop the first big hit of 2021 like DJ Neptune did for Nobody last year, 2020? Let's have your comment, let's have your thoughts, let's have your reactions. Guys, please, no fighting in the comment section. It's 2021, it's a new year, guys.
New year,
be
new
holy.
New year, new you.
Be new. New year, new you. Yes, be holy. Be holy and put your comment there and just waka. Thank you so much for always supporting us. Thank you. We appreciate every one of you. We'll see you on the next one. I'll tell a lie again. Tule, dog. Tule, Dari. Tule.